channel. I'm Morgan Monet. In today's video, I'm going to be doing the All About My Luxury Bags video tag. I think that's the best way to say it. But there are basically 13 various questions, and based on those questions, I tell you guys which bag best represents that category for me. You may have seen other videos like this on YouTube, and I love them, so I decided to recreate it. If this is your first time watching any of my videos, well, welcome. It's been 2 months since I've, you know, last recorded, but I'm glad that you are here. I am back better than ever. This pandemic has been tough, but if you are new, you should definitely subscribe by hitting the red button below. I create content around luxury accessories, such as handbags and SLGs. So without further ado, let's get started. And actually, before we get started, I want to show you guys this amazing jewelry that was gifted to me by Ana Luisa. They are having a Black Friday sale for basically the whole entire month of November, but I am obsessed with this brand. They have exceptional quality, fair pricing. I mean, some of their luxury items are under $40. Like, you cannot beat that at all. And they're carbon neutral. So they're luxury, but with a conscience. And I love the way the jewelry looks on me. And I'm just so thankful that they have decided to sponsor me. So I will also leave the information down in the description box and give you guys the link across, you know, the bottom of the video. But I just think that the jewelry is beautiful, and you guys, it's really great for sensitive skin. But this jewelry has just been phenomenal, and I love this heart necklace and these hoop earrings. All right, let's get started. Okay, you guys, so the first question in this All About My Luxury Bags bag tag is, what is your newest luxury handbag? And mine is the beautiful Gucci Dionysus in the large. Oh my goodness, you guys, I just recently got this bag and I am obsessed and I love it. Here's the front, the sides, and of course the back. This back pocket is amazing, but this is my newest bag. Question number two is, what is your oldest bag? And you guys should know this one. It is my Louis Vuitton Neverfull in the MM size in the Damier Azure canvas with the beautiful, as I always say, the beautiful rose ballerine interior. This was the handbag that started my obsession with luxury handbags, and I couldn't have been happier to make this guy my first designer purchase. Question number three is, what is your most expensive luxury bag? And that would have to be my Gucci Dionysus. If you purchase this guy in the boutique, it is around $2,500, not including taxes, but you can buy it on pre-hand websites to get it for a less expensive price. So just if you don't want to spend that much money, you have other options. Question number four is, what is your least expensive luxury bag? And this one for me is a two-part. So part number one would be, if you're looking at the prices or the retails of the bags right now, it would definitely be my Gucci Marmont Matalassi Mini as my least expensive bag, because this retails for $1,100. But if you were to say, which is my least expensive bag when I purchased it, it would definitely be my Speedy 30 without the bandolier strap, because when I purchased this bag back in 2017, it was between $700 and $900 in the boutique. But as of right now, this bag is $1,160. So just $60 more than my Gucci Mini. Question number five is, what is your everyday bag? And mine is my Neverfull in the GM size in the Damier Abene canvas. I typically reach for this guy if I have to travel or on day to day. It's just really the best for me because it carries and holds so much. And I actually have a video describing this bag in full detail, so I will link that both above and below. So question number six is, what is the bag with the best memory? And that would have to be my Chloe Marcy bag. And it's really because my boyfriend purchased this for me for my 26th birthday this past year. And he got it during the pandemic, you know. It was a lot going on, but he was just like, you're worth it. And he took the plunge and he got this bag for me. And so I think that's why it has just the best memory, because it was my bright spot during this terrible pandemic. Question number seven is, which bag is worth the hype? And that for me would have to be the Louis Vuitton Pochette Matisse. You guys, this is the best crossbody bag I have ever had. It holds so much. There are three pockets in the bag. There's also a zipper pocket in the back. I have also done a full review on this bag. Again, I'll link it both above and below, but this bag is definitely worth the hype, in my opinion. I think that everybody should really look at getting this, and it comes in multiple canvases and leather options. So definitely my Pochette Matisse. Question number eight is, which luxury bag is not worth the hype? And that for me would have to be my Louis Vuitton Felicia in this beautiful magenta color. A lot of people love and gravitate toward this handbag because it's crossbody, number one, but then you also get two smaller SLGs with it. So you get this like bill holder and then a card holder. But for me, it's just not worth the hype because I don't reach for it that often, and it really doesn't fit that many things. You can really only hold the essentials. So maybe some keys, some lip gloss, and then cash and bills. But for me, it's just really not worth the hype. And I really, if I'm being honest, I don't use it that often. Question number nine is, what is your favorite bag from your favorite brand? And my favorite brand is definitely Louis Vuitton. And my favorite bag from my Louis Vuitton collection would have to be my Neverfull in the MM size in the Damier Azur canvas. I just love this bag. I love the pink interior. And it was my first bag. So I love it. I really do. It's my favorite bag and it makes me happy. I'm smiling super, super hard right now. Question number 10 is, what is your most used bag? And mine would definitely have to be, once again, my Louis Vuitton Neverfull in the MM size. I've had it the longest. It goes with majority of my outfits. Like, this is definitely 100% my most used bag, hands down. Question number 11 is, what is your most underrated handbag? And that for me would have to be my Chloe Marcy in the medium size. And that's really only because a lot of people don't talk about this bag. And it's a classic. It's truly a classic. It's an all-over leather bag. It has beautiful lining on the inside. You have a pocket over here, two pockets on the other side, and you also have this pocket in the front, which it's fighting me, but you also have this pocket in the front. And a lot of people don't talk about this bag. And it's just a beautiful bag, and it holds so much. And I love it, honestly, I love it. Question number 12 is, what is your most nostalgic bag? And that for me would have to be my Louis Vuitton Neverfull in the GM size. And that's mainly because I bought this bag with my boyfriend for our 2-year anniversary when we went to Paris. So I had the best experience in the Louis Vuitton in Paris. The boutique was beautiful. The customer service was amazing. They gave us champagne. Like, every time I carry this bag, I think back to that amazing experience, and it just makes me love the bag that much more. Okay, last but certainly not least, question number 13, which is the final question, is, what is your most disappointing bag? And that for me would have to be my Speedy 30. And hear me out, you guys, it's really only because I did not get this bag with the bandolier strap. If I would have purchased this bag with the bandolier strap, it would definitely not be my most disappointing bag. But carrying this Speedy as a top handle only, handbag is very challenging, and it can get very heavy. So I have to say that this one is my most disappointing, and it's my fault because I'm the one that purchased it without the bandolier strap. All right, you guys, so that's the end of this video. Please be sure to give it a big thumbs up. And also, don't forget to check out the link below on the Ana Luisa jewelry. Again, they're having this amazing Black Friday sale. And it's really just, you guys, the jewelry is both dainty and bold. I know for a fact that you can pair it with any of your outfits. And I also love the fact that it was shipped in this recyclable cardboard and that it was so underrated. So I mean, who would think that this was jewelry? And that's actually safer for your purchase. Not to mention that the items came in these beautiful Ana Luisa felt bags to where you can store your jewelry. It has a button closure, but you can also use it to like clean off your jewelry. So I really am falling in love with the brand, and I really think that you guys would love it too. So definitely be sure to check that out below, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!